Welcome back, everybody, here to your second last day at the Star Ladder Finals, where we come to you with the first final of the lower bracket, where Mousesports facing up against Adara, where we're at the point, guys, where if you lose, you are out. There is no more for you. The win, however, will advance forward to face up against Moscow 5, possibly later tonight, possibly earlier tomorrow morning, and then the winner of that goes into the grand final to face up against Na'Vi for the coveted title, the Star Ladder Finals. Who will get there? We're going to find out, jumping ourselves inside the draft, which has just begun, and in fact, they're going pretty damn fast as well. So let me quickly introduce to you my co-commentator. The crowd demands him, and luckily he is a man for the crowd, of the people, from the people, and here for the people. How you doing, Sind?
Good, I'm good. Fresh and from the shower, so I'm ready to watch some good Dota right now between Dara and Mousesports. Of course, this is the, what did you call this, the lower bracket first final? Let's call it that.
First final of the lower bracket, yes.
Yeah, so in reality, the lower bracket semi-final. It's going to be played out now between Dara and Mousesports. Dara on the Radiant side, Mousesports on the Dire. We've got Dara with the first pick, have chosen to ban out the Darkseer, Brood, as well as Chen, while Mousesports have removed, they always remove that Wisp, as it seems, and then they've removed the Lone Druid and the Lycan with that. So that's a first pick profit for Dara. And Mousesport pounces back with Chaos Knight, Enigma. Chaos Knight is really the story of this event so far, in my opinion. And Dara are now picking up the Leshrac. So they've got some... Yeah, there's not too much to say about this just yet, apart from the fact that Chaos Knight gets picked very early in this event.
Yeah, Mousesports go with it, because we have been talking about all these combinations. We still haven't been able to see that combination of Wisps, CK. It just has not happened for us. But hey, who knows? There's still another set of matches to go, so we might see it in the future. But CK, you're all right. He has been the kind of story of it all. And most CK teams... I think the percentage now is like up to 60% for his win rate or something like that. It's not that big as much as you'd expect, because CK is so reliant on that early farm, reliant on being a tank. It can always be counted around. Like, we've now got Windrunner, we've now got Leshrac, we've now got Prophet. So we've got Global Push, we've got Fast Push, and we've got a good sideline hero. Where Mousesports, they look to keeping themselves in front through CK's farm, which he'll be protected. Enigma inside the jungle as well. So Mousesports already looking pretty good as far as that goes. But you're right, there's not much more to really say with these first three picks. Like we always see, Sim, these first three picks are pretty standard. It's just what happens in this last stage of the draft, which keeps on going a little bit awry with both teams.
And the question is what Mousesports are going to go for now. I could see them getting the support for Chaos Knight, and it is going to be Shadow Demon as their third pick right now. So they've possibly set up a lane with Shadow Demon, Chaos Knight at this point.
I'm feeling the Kunkka mid, man. I'm feeling the dual lane mid.
Well, if they want to do that, they either need a support for Chaos Knight or need to run him solo, and then Enigma has to run off lane, so they don't even have a Wooda then.
True.
If that's what
in that case, my feeling is wrong. It's not necessarily wrong.
They could run the solo Enigma. They've done it sometimes for Sing Sing, for example, but yeah, we'll have to see what they choose to do here. First ban out from Dara in the second phase is going to be Tinker, so a little bit worried about that global presence. And I'm not sure, did Dara lose to Tinker yesterday one or two times? I think they did, right? Moscow 5 were really taking it to them with Admirations Tinker in one of the games, I remember. So maybe they just don't want to have to deal with that. Oh. There's no real setup for a Tinker for the Dire as such here. It's not... It's good counter-pushing and it's good ganking power, etc. That's what the hero does, but there's no real reason why Tinker would be a fantastic pick here, in my opinion. So maybe it's just one of those heroes there are like, we can't be bothered. Remove it.
Well, unless they just want all that global push power for themselves, but there's many ways that Mouse can do that. And when I ever see Mouse go up with a Shadow Demon, they're not looking for as such push, they're looking to win their lanes very early on. That's always what they look for. You get that Shadow Demon, you got great initiation, so you're looking for kills as much as you possibly can, and they've got the Enigma jungle, so they're looking just to hold the balance when it comes to lanes, when it comes to maps, and when it comes to about that 20-minute mark. So CK, he'll really start to hit his stride then if he's protected enough that he has, well, basically unstoppable farm. And that's why Mousesports, they remove out those guys that really do the damage when it comes to mid-game and heroes which Dara like to use, just like the Nightstalker. So they're removing him out of play. But you are right, that Ticket Bandits, it's kind of standard for this tournament, but it doesn't really 100% really ban anything out that Mousesports would want to look for.
And I don't recall Mousesports really playing with Tinker either.
No.
I don't think they ever play this hero. I could be mistaken, but I don't think they do.
It's not one of the normal things, man.
But you're right about Nightstalker. I think, if I remember correctly, Mousesports banned this in every single game as the fourth ban.
Yeah.
I really think they did. They have a problem with this hero, so maybe it's the Dara Tinker syndrome. We don't want to play against this hero. Get rid of it.
I'll probably go with that, man. I'm waiting for them to ban out the Invoker as their final one, because we're still going to remember Mouseports. Sing Sing, we haven't seen him a single time actually play that Invoker. Not a single time we managed to see that happen just yet.
I don't think he will either. He's playing the Chaos Knight for them, right?
Normally he does, but Black.
I think they're a one Invoker for themselves.
Black could take up that role as well. So could Bamboo. That's the cool thing. However, Bamboo onto the Enigma is kind of what I love seeing. But then again, Come With Me does a good Enigma as well, and 1437's no mug with him. I really love the depth in the Mouseports lineup. Like, you instantly think, SK. Well, you could be looking at Kalmi, you could be looking at Black, you could be looking at Sexy Bamboo. They've just got so much variety for even just signature heroes there.
And we'll see with the Morphling ban now for Dera. I still think they could be going for the Invoker. Wasn't this what they had in one of the games yesterday? Did they have Prophet and Invoker, or did they only have one of them?
You're talking about Dera.
Yes. I think Dera will. They might pick the Invoker. It's a hero God loves to play. He doesn't necessarily have a hero just yet here. The Prophet will be played by Goblin in the Woods. Windrunner for Mag on top. And the Leshrac could be played by God. It could be played as a support by Funic. And in that case, God still has a hero open. But it's also likely that God will take the solo mid Leshrac here. But he's going to have a really hard time if Mouseports choose to dual lane there with a Chaos Knight plus one. That's not a lane Leshrac likes. The problem for Leshrac is he's very fragile. He's good range, good harassment damage, good stun, but he can't really stand against a strong dual lane that Mouseports could pull out with Chaos Knight plus one. He gets dragged into the river, has 500 hit points, and then he dies. Mm-hmm. They're going to ban the Invoker, so maybe they thought Dera would pick Invoker like I thought. Looks like they were really, really instantly picking up their Clinks, though, so that was planned from the get-go. I think we'll see Artstyle playing that.
Yeah.
Seems he's taken the carry role of that team, but in my opinion, not really an art style type of hero. He likes playing these strength initiators. We saw him yesterday with Skeleton King and Chaos Knight. Clinks is not that type of hero. He's not really an opener. He's not a tank. Well, arguably, he's kind of a tank if he uses his ultimate, but the way Clinks works is that he wants the enemy to go on his allies, and then he suddenly stabs them. Mm-hmm. Not his allies, the enemies.
Yeah. I know what you mean, man.
And Earthshaker for Mouseports is also kind of unusual, I think. We haven't seen them playing that this much. Let's phrase it like that. And I'm not sure what the reasoning is. Maybe they're concerned about the pushing power from the Radiant, that Leshrac and Prophet can push them down too hard and they can't hold, and then they need the Earthshaker Fissure to block off and protect their towers, because he doesn't really have that much synergy with, for example, a ranged hero that Mouseports has, because they don't really have a ranged damage dealer. They have Chaos Knight as their carry. So
it's a babysit hero. It's a babysitter.
Yeah, but who's he going to babysit?
Mouse's bot lane, whoever that is.
They're running Enigma Woods.
It's Enigma top lane. Sing Sing did this earlier in the competition where they ran Enigma for the solo top lane. They ran CK Shadow Demon in towards the middle lane. And the rest of that lineup can be done however you want it to be done, but I just see that Earthshaker as a support for whoever runs on that bottom lane.
Then I think we're going to see a Queen of Pain for Bamboo, because I think it's a really good pick here. Sand King is going to be the last one for Dera, so that's probably Funix hero here, the Sand King. Going to see God on the Lesh and Artstyle on the Clinks.
Don't you give Mag the Windrunner?
Yeah, for sure. He's played it every game they had it. So I'd be surprised if... As always, you can change the roles around and you can put the lanes differently, but to me, Dera's laning is pretty predictable at this point. Or is it? Sand King Clinks easy lane? Maybe. I don't know. It's not really that good lane. We'll see what they do. I think Mouseports will choose to opt for that Queen of Pain at this point. I think it's a really good pick for them. Great AoE damage. There's not so many counters on the Radiant until Clinks gets his Orchid, of course. Mm-hmm. They have the stun from Sand King, but that's it to really catch Queen of Pain off guard. And she can move around pretty freely and gives a lot of AoE potential that Mouseports love to play with. So it's a good pick for Bamboo. It's also one of his best heroes. And with the Shaker, that's a good offlane for you. And that was not expected at all. Why are they getting AM?
Oh.
What the...
This is going to lead to an aggressive tri-lane. No, that makes no sense.
I don't know.
How are they going to lane this? Let's check it out. I want to see who's playing what right now. Black, not a... Obviously, going to go the Anti-Mage. Always the biggest farmer hard carry. Sing Sing into Chaos Knight, 1437 Shadow Demon, Come With Me Enigma, and Sexy Bamboo instead of Come With Me will be taking up the role as the Earthshaker, which is unusual because it's one of Kamui's most favorite heroes. Over towards the Dera side, we will have Funnik, as you were right, playing as the SK in this scenario. Artstyle will be taking up the Lashrak, not the Klinks in this case. Godkill the Maul will be taking up Klinks. Goblin is the Prophet Jungler. And Mag, he is our steady one. He's playing as the Windrunner.
Yeah, surprised to see Artstyle taking the Lashrak. This is not really his kind of hero. Looking forward to seeing how he performs with this one. He's, in my opinion, really stepped up at this event. He's been criticized a lot for not playing on the level he used to. I think a couple of the games we've seen from Artstyle here in this tournament has really shown that he's still a very strong player. Played a fantastic Chaos Knight as well as Skeleton King the other day. The Skeleton King game was not really his fault. In my opinion, they were just outdrafted and it was a strange game overall. But he played solidly himself with that Skeleton King. So he's really back on track with his core heroes, namely those melee strength. But we're going to see if he can also handle this solo mid intelligence role, which is very, very different from what he usually plays. For Mousesports, however, they're playing exactly what they usually do. Black on that hard carry AM, Sing Sing on the Chaos Knight, farming the, whatever lane he goes on. 1437 on his ever so faithful Shadow Demon. Sexy Bamboo on the Earthshaker, which is something we have seen a couple of times, but it's been a while, I think.
Yeah.
Finally come with me on that Enigma. I have no idea how these guys are going to lane. I don't understand this lineup, laning-wise. We'll see what they choose to do. Maybe they run CK... CK solo mid, perhaps? And then Shaker Enigma bottom? Or maybe Shaker solo bottom?
I don't know, man. Bamboo's
items could indicate that he's going solo bottom. Look at what he has. He's got a lot of HP regen. And 3 clarities just to get creep kills with Fissure, I guess. The battle begins. This is very strange.
Either that or Bamboo just becomes nothing double but a Roma. Rune goes towards the top lane and Black picks that up. So double damage for him.
Oh, this is the mouse strategy with all those tangos. Black has 3 tangos, 1 salve, and 6 tangos. Got a lot of regen out of...
It makes it solo, so he can stand here on the lane, use up his consumables, which means 1437 Sing Sing lane and middle lane does work. We do, however, have a really strong lane by Daryl. That SK with the Lashrak is a really pain-in-the-ass kind of lane to work, and that's why 1437 is going to remain here. But we look at God Kill Them All in this bottom lane, probably feeling he can harass Come With Me a hell of a lot down here. But Bamboo, he is that babysit, man. He's the babysitting bot lane. I was half-right about it. Completely wrong with the heroes. But we are right about this Earthshaker. Just here to babysit Come With Me down here on the bottom lane.
Yeah, and the decision for Mousesports here to put Black Solo top, I think, is a really good one. I was very confused by their laning, but it makes some sense now. That what confused me before was that Come With Me generally plays that Enigma in the woods, but if they want to lane it, this is the best laning setup they can do. And as always, 1437 has thought his lanes through, but... Yeah, because they give Black all these tangos, he should be perfectly fine against Mag, or maybe even win the top lane if he gets a good opening at one point, and can put a lot of pressure on Mag here and perhaps outfarm him as well. Mm-hmm. As far as the mid lane goes, it's hard to predict. It's about who makes the first mistake, in my opinion. Shadow Demon can really nicely counter this stun combo from Dera, but if they get in somehow on 1437, he could find himself dead very quickly, and Sing Sing cannot protect him alone. And finally down the bot lane, this is going to be a nightmare for God, by the way, playing against the Enigma and Shaker with his Klink solo. Because Goblin, he will not help him out just yet. Goblin is a farming prophet in the beginning. He needs levels, and he needs the Midas, and that's going to take some time.
That is true, man. And God, his biggest problem right now is he probably thought he was going to have a lot more room here on the bottom lane. Normally you'd say, it's going to be a throwaway lane. But you got Earthshaker, who's now rotating up towards the top lane, by the way. Bamboo's left that bottom lane. But the Earthshaker adding the early pressure on with the Fissure, making him just start to use up his tango. He's only got one more charge on the tango, and then it's south time. And that's going to be all. Mid lane in the meantime, Arstyle being set up here by Sing. Fissure will fly out by Bamboo. Catcher has landed on Arstyle. Destruction will go up by 1437. Is it a block? No, it is not. Well, it is on Funnik, but they clear off one of the trees and they're able to get themselves around.
Yeah, I think Dera could have actually taken the first blood here if Funnik was a little bit more ballsy in that play. Could have taken a stun on Sing Sing. He was very close to them with only one third of his HP, and Artstyle soon to come out of that disruption. But nevertheless, I think Dera is still going to be pretty happy that they didn't die from this three-man attempt from Mousesports. Mm-hmm. And they stay alive and heal up.
Kind of almost feels like a passing attempt as well. Just the fact that, well, it was a Fissure thrown out there. It might have got the kill, but it still split it up. There was no real prep. There was no invis rune to give him a better position to start off with. So it was a bit of a, let's try it. We'll see if we're successful. 1437 is going to swipe the rune there from Funnik. but it just doesn't seem like a proper kill. Come with me, however. Going on God here. He's going to jump himself inside the invis in a moment. Nope, he'll be okay. He saves the mana. But those conversions, and come with me, really controlling off God here. Now he's got that soul ring up.
Yeah, he could be in a lot of trouble in this bottom lane, and maybe Prophet will come in to help on the lane. That's not good for Dera if he has to do that. Because they want God to get this good farm early on. He's currently trying to farm up Eidolons. It's more like they're farming him. And up top, Bamboo now. Up against Mag. Mag doesn't have the mana for a Windrun anymore, so this is a big problem for him on that offlane. Now Black has successfully drained all that mana, and we might see an attempt here.
Yep, there's the blink. Fissure, gonna fly through, but oh, it's on the wrong side. Only just on the wrong side.
It couldn't have killed him anyway, but they keep the pressure up. And Mag uses that salve. He's in a lot of trouble up here now. Black has this lane completely under control, and there's nothing Mag can do about it. God is also in trouble bottom, so far so good for Mousebot's lanes.
He just flew a salve out to him, but forced to use it instantly. And bought boots instead of that, a ring of Aquila, which he wanted to have. That way he could have his mana spam out those searing arrows, but now he has to be a lot more cautious with what he uses. And Bamboo again is rotating. He's moved from top, he's heading down south. Goes Black, he controls this top lane. Windrunner can't stay close. He just sucks that mana out. Yeah, 100% right, man. How are you supposed to stand up in this top lane when you have no Windrun and you're never quite sure where the Earthshaker is, unless you got a ward spotting him? And he's going to take another rune now. Have Dera even got one rune? I think there's actually all three runes, two double damage runes plus an illusion rune going the way of Mousebots.
It's very true. They've claimed all the runes so far. Now 1-4-3-7 getting the top DD here with the bottle.
Well, Enigma actually kills off Klinks.
Single-handedly. I wasn't even looking for that because that shouldn't be possible.
It's 1v2 as well. Goblin was part of that. He TP'd in to try and help with that, and come with me, he's already on the way out. The first blood should have happened in mid or top. But hey, we're off to a good start today for all the joined out viewers. Yeah. Now middle lane. Disruption starts off. 1-4-3-7. He's got the double damage rune. 2 second stun. Oh wow, that's a lot of damage. Nice Burrow strike out by Funnik. But Sing Sing and 1-4-3-7 just nailed Lashrak down the mid.
Yeah, if he gets caught in this combo, he can't really survive it. The damage from Mousebot here is very strong, and of course Lashrak, like I said earlier, very fragile here on the lane. Now he's bought a Bracer. He's getting tankability over mobility here. He's not getting boots or anything. Maybe we can see a counter go here. Funnik, does he want to try it? He's going to counter go on Sing Sing here.
Gotta be careful.
Trouble. Oh,
2 seconds stun. Lashrak's stun might have helped him out there, but Shadow Demon still right-clicking him down.
Sing Sing getting really lucky with the damage on Chaos Bolt just there. He dealt like 240 or something out of 250. And that hurts.
The second time he got really, really lucky with that high damage. I was watching up on top lane as well. Bamboo was waiting. He was prepping himself so long for this. And he really wanted this kill. But it didn't happen in the end. But they've still got Mag on nothing. Mag has got 4 levels and a half. And he got actually, he's managed to get 18 for 5 for this farm. He's almost keeping up here with Black. Sing Sing really low on life right now. Klinks again being solo killed off by the Enigma. 1-4-3-7, however, keeps on going in art style. Sing Sing's putting himself back in. He's low, low life. The stun will fly through, and there goes 1-4-3-7. So he's just not feeling like he can do anything. But currently, it's a second solo kill for him down there on the bottom lane up against the Klinks.
Yeah, he's got a sentry ward. He used the black hole for that kill.
Ah, that'll be why.
But still, if Enigma is crushing this lane, it's looking super good for Mousebots right now. Golden XP largely in their favor already 6 minutes in. And it's not only about that, it's also about the map positioning that Enigma is so strong right now that he can start even challenging Goblin.
Look for the Haste Rune. Haste Rune SK, looking for Bamboo. Burrow strikes. Artstyle, will he get there in time? Power shot, stun, too far away. He's got no burst damage, and Black now follows down. Artstyle, he loses off all of his mana with 2 hits. Popping off the Edict. And Black will look to go back in again. Is there another fissure or a stun by Sting? There's the hit. And again! Come with me, just keeps on ripping that bottom lane. Arstyle, 2 second stun, and down he goes. Anime shakes the last hit again. But come with me.
He got some help this time.
Yeah, he got 1-4-3-7 to help him off.
That's going to give 1-4-3-7 his level 6 as well. So now that demonic purge is up. And the problem for Dera right now, they're playing 4 and 5. Goblin is not participating yet because he wants to get his Midas. He almost has it. Wrath of Nature is finally available for him, but they're investing a lot into this Wooding Prophet because he's not helping them out with ganking in the mid lane, for example, where, in my opinion, we could have seen a lot of setup kills with that Sand King Lashrak and just a TPing Prophet, but they farm the Prophet. They always do that. And he's very hesitant to TP in for anything.
The problem is his farm isn't paying off. Is he Sing Sing initiating? 4 seconds on here on Arsar. Nice double burrow strike there by Funnik. And they're eating damage will do a lot. And there's your Prophet Ultimate helping out. And they get a double kill here in the middle lane for Terra. And now I think God
really
was
good
a little
stun
bit...
for Funnik there. Great job finding the double stun here. There was a hard angle he had to get, but he got it on time. Even the 4 seconds stun from Sing Sing was not enough to keep Art Style locked down.
Come with me. This time I'm not going to miss it, man. Going to go on God. The stuns keep him flying out there, but he's out of range of the sentry ward and the conversion.
I'm glad you
off.
Spotted this one. He's 650 HP from dying.
What? Damn you to hell, Sin. Damn you to hell.
Let's look at Link's. Oh, this time he's not dying.
I can watch a middle lane. T1 tower is brought down by the Radiant. Funnik, he is catching up, but they cannot bring him out of this. 2 points up on that Sandstorm too, so he can channel that to the full extent.
And
there's
the
no
question
infants.
Is they're going to try this one. Sing Sing is a little hesitant here, and so is 1437. If they get into a double stun, this could be
there
a
we
kill.
Go. There we go, Reality Rift. Nice timing on the Barrow. Breaks the vision, even for an instant there of Sing Sing, meaning the Reality Rift can't follow through. You are such a troll, Sin.
Oh, we're looking for Black. He's now 41 for 20. Mm-hmm. So he's getting good farm up on top. Enigma's getting good farm down on bottom. But that's pretty much all there is. Chaos Knight is not getting good farm. And we know how this hero works. Get him big, he gets strong. Get him not so big. Well, he has a stun then, but he can't really play his role of tank with that Phantasm either.
Come with me, bottom lane man. You got to check this out right now. There goes a Purge. Catcher as well. Kalmi can follow up with the stuns already, and there's a Fissure out from Bamboo. But Funnik going to channel up the Epicenter, but unfortunately, Come With Me is already dead down there on the bottom lane. And then Reality Rift almost pulls Funnik back. 1437. He was caught on the wrong side of the Fissure. Now sprouted up. Lands off the Catcher on the Prophet. The Clinks wants to keep on right-clicking out, but not going to happen. Do we just have a buyback then? Yeah, Come With Me instantly bought back. They're going to look for this T1 tower on bot then. Oh, what's happening on top lane? Black chasing down Mag, back past the tower. He's got a blink to do this. He has 3 chances to right click him and he cancels his attack every single time. And then gets shackled. I don't know if Black was just trying
to be... This rebuy from Come With Me is going to give them a tier 1.
Yeah. Split between the team as well. I don't understand what Black was doing up there in that top lane. Do you see that? Could have right-click wound on her 3 times and decided not to every single time.
Yeah, he just cancelled his attack a millisecond too early. He wants to not do the full swing. He wants to save time on the attacks, but...
God. In an interesting position.
He's giving a lot of good vision to Artstyle right now.
Trying to look for this stunt and Come With Me. There's the stunt. Gonna get it. And right-click. Goodbye, Come With Me. He'll end up one last stun here on Artstyle. But that's gonna be all. And that's a big kill as well. That's good experience. That's a level 9 3/4 Enigma.
Yep. And that XP is going to be split between God and Artstyle. So getting some much needed level on these two heroes. Especially for Artstyle, I have to say. He needs to get a little bit more tankability so he can be a force in these fights. His big problem is he's playing against an Anti-Mage, which is one of the really good heroes against Leshrac. Because Leshrac, the way he works, he's an all-out mana bomb. You go in and you use everything you've got. Pulse Nova, Edict, Stun... And then you're low on mana, and then Anti-Mage is like...
Sweet.
Oh, sweet. And if you're next to an ally, it's like, double sweet. Then you both die.
And how much of your mana pool have you now lost? How much damage can be done? That wonderful mana void, man. And looks like Mouseport's going to try and take out these T1 towers. It's really smart from them as well. Like they've lost their T1 tower, remember, but they still hold their ones on the side. And Prophet, CP are going to come in. Funnik misses on the Burrow Strike and all the heroes. Sentry Ward down, drop down. Reality Rift pulling Mag a little bit closer. Nice stun out by Arstyle. Catching all 3 heroes. Follows up with the Epicenter from Funnik. Great combo. In fact, all 4 heroes from Mouseports obliterated. What a stun by Arstyle.
Yeah, excellent timing here from Arstyle on that level 4 stun. Well, maybe it was only level 3 when he cast it, actually, but... A really good placement of that. Gets a full Epicenter off as well on all 3 heroes that remain. And a bad decision here from Mouse to try and go for this one. They paid a lot for that. They had an advantage, and now I think... Yep, no,
they just gave 3k worth of experience, or at least over the past 1 minute. Gave a good chunk of gold, too. Almost 2k worth of gold. And didn't claim a tower. And that's Arstyle's Arcanes, I'm guessing. Yeah, it is. He's not going to go tank. He's going to go to that Bloodstone. Or at least we can assume.
God, putting some pressure top. Shackle.
Nicely done. Funny can follow Ace. You already used the Burrow Strike right now, and there's Black blinking away.
Yeah, doing a lot of damage, though, and forcing him off his lane, and that's... It's not always about getting the kill. It's just as much about controlling the carry so he can't farm. And you see Black, there's free farm under his tower, but he can't go. He knows Sand King and Windrun are here, so effectively they're locking down Black without killing him right now.
That's why Bamboo came in. Mouseballs, they're going mid lane again. There's Reality Rip pulling Mag back in again. 3 seconds stun, Kalmi follow-up. Catches there, lands on Mag as well, but the tower goes down. So just meaning Mag won't want to follow through. Funnick will go through the conversions. And Mag, wow, he's really, really low. That had to be purged as well.
Bottom with God.
And Black was looking for Funnick. Try and dive in this middle lane. Black for the first time leaving that top lane. Klinks does take the bottom tower.
Just seems like this game is going to be a quota 2 game between Prophet and Anti-Mage.
This blink by Black.
Prophet is farming so much right now. And he's still participating in kills with his ultimate. He has Midas, 2600. He's probably going to buy the 4 stuff like he usually does. I still think they need a mechanism. If Prophet gets this good farm, why is he not buying the mechanism?
Or is he going Necro?
Unless Windrunner. Okay, Windrunner might be doing that. So
he could be
they don't really need a pipe. Pipe isn't that good here for Dera. So if Wind gets the mechanism, Prophet can get damage items. And he's going for not a 4 stuff, but Aghanim Scepter. He wants to just get that ridiculous farming and pushing build up that Goblin likes to play. We generally don't see many Nature's Prophets going for the Aghanim Scepter, but Goblin seems to always favor it.
You always feel like you go the Aghanim Scepter if you feel you can't control the lanes enough. Or if you're always wanting to be inside the jungle. It's the only time I will ever build an Aghanim Scepter up on a Prophet is when you just cannot control the lanes properly. But if you pop off that Aghanim Scepter with the Prophet ultimate, and you got at least a level 2 up on that ultimate, you obliterate the entire wave. There's... Generally, you'll push out every single wave with just one ultimate. And because of that, it forces your opposition to go back on the back foot. Watching Black about to be ganked up here on the bottom lane. God kind of wants to go for this, but 1437 is here. They got no vision. Bamboo and the back lines. What a time for a Fissure. Holding out Arcel, holding out God. There goes the Purge as well as Catcher. Black, he just wanted to get his ultimate off right then. Funnick Burrow striked him down. Reality Rip pulls Funnick back in again. And one Sentry Ward there. He tried to go into Sandstorm, but he cannot hide there. But he does save the life there of Klinks, and that's more important.
Yeah, God manages to get out there with 100 HP, so probably worth the sacrifice here from Funnick. And they need to make sure that God gets up his farm, because, well, he was crippled a lot in the beginning, so he has a lot of catching up to do right now. Not even close to the Orchid 16 minutes in. He still needs about 1.5k.
Smoke gang time. Goblin, they found him. They found him. 4 seconds stun with the catcher, and goodbye.
Thus I confound the Prophet.
What?! The Psychon found the Prophet?
What does that even... I just love Shaker's voice.
What does that even so mean? Good. Come with me, dead on the top lane. Mag, actually, he's really, really low. Those conversions try and do their job. What you get for a Sunstrike right now?
And Artstyle has gone for those Arcane Boots on his Leshrac, so his mana pool is really big, and that can be both good and bad for him when playing against an AM. But he's certainly able to get his spells off at this point. We'll probably see him going for a BKB as his next item so he can avoid getting completely locked down by this Dire lineup, which is very stun intensive. There's CK, there's Enigma, there's Shadow Demon for the disruption, there's Shaker Fissure, and of course the big thing, Mana Void, which he can avoid by using the BKB. So would be a very good item choice for Artstyle. He's got 2 braces as well, so his tankability is pretty good. And with a BKB, he'll have around those 12, 1300 HP when he gets that at that point. Should be pretty okay.
Black!
Oh, look at Black!
Just blinks in and ulties him. He's got one more blink and he's got this. But look at Funnick. Funnick is waiting for it. And Black knows he's waiting for it as well. In the meantime, Klink just shuts down 1437 and is rotating to help. Oh, nice Fissure. Really nice Fissure there by Bamboo. Stops God's TP. He was trying to go down towards that bottom lane to just go up and farm after he got that kill. But that was really nice bait out by Dera.
Yeah, I'm not sure that was a bait. I don't think Artstyle had been doing the exact calculation on how much damage he would take from that monster. That looked pretty scary. But he did survive it, and they got a kill for it. And interesting to see Black, he's got the Ring of Health, and what we usually see Anti-Mages do at this point is get either the Vanguard or the Battle Fury, but he's chosen to buy an Ultimate Orb. So we might see him going for a very early Manta style, or You won't get a Lincoln's, right?
No.
There's no way he's getting a Lincoln's on AM.
The way Black Bill is, I remember I was talking to him about this at DreamHack, and I think I quoted him a couple of times during a broadcast, and the way he always looks at Animage is, he really feels like, farm-wise, he can do that normally. He doesn't need a Battle Fury to do it. Sure, it helps him farm up inside the jungle, but he wants to be part of the lanes. Mousesports are a very aggressive team, so why would you want to get something which makes you very, very passive? So what he likes to do is get yourself as close as you can to that Vanguard, but if you can get your Mana Soul, get it as early as possible. Get that damage out, get your stats up, just have enough regen from the ring, and then you're good to go.
Okay, so this is a normal build for Black? I've seen it before.
This is actually quite normal for Black to do. The only thing which is slightly unusual is the fact he didn't buy the Vitality Booster and properly finish the Vanguard.
That's what I mean.
But still, it goes along the same lines. And Chaos Knight brought down here in the middle lane by Funnik as well as Artstyle, but the top lane T1 tower is going to be where the next fight's going to be. Or is it?
Yeah, but can they push it? Prophet Ultimate with Aghanim's. Level 2 Prophet Ultimate with Aghanim's is pretty good for holding tower.
Oh, man. That stun came close. Sentry wards are going up. Black wants to go back in on this one. Blink in. Pops the old one. Funnik is still visible. Shackle won't latch. And they get the kill on the Earthshaker. While Sankin goes down, Earthshaker was trying to defend that bottom lane. But it was Goblin as well as God teaming up for that one. Man, this is going everywhere on the map.
They're getting pushed on two fronts, and they're only not even pushing one. They're losing a bit of their bottom tier 2 and a lot of their middle tier 2 here, not claiming the tier 1. So, although Funnik dies with that, I still think it was a pretty good trade for Dara here to hold that tower. And God, from that kill bottom, almost has his... Actually, does have his Orchid now, 19 minutes in. Considering his poor start, this is pretty good for him. And he has recovered. He was 0-3-0, now he's 4-3-0, and has 88 CS 20 minutes in after that start. It's pretty good.
Question is, how much can you make of this? Orchid is always great, but the biggest thing which you got to use when you have Orchid is get yourself out there and look for these kills. And the problem he's going to have is when Bamboo does something like this, where he drops down just a rando sentry ward down there on the bottom lane, it's a little bit further out than the tower, they're waiting for God to come and gank here on Black. And when he does do so, and there we go, there's that sentry ward's waiting for. The Fissure, Black, however, decides to stand, to run away right now. God's still on the move, there goes the element, jumps him down, and he just has only just enough mana after those stick charges to pop that skeleton walk.
Yeah, and Black was a little too intimidated here. By God, he should have, like you said, he should have really taken that fight when Bamboo came in with that Fissure. That would have been an easy kill for Mousesports.
Mm-hmm.
But Black might have been afraid that there was more heroes coming in. He's probably not expecting Klinks to try to open on him alone.
But when you got that Orchid, you will. You'll always open alone.
I don't think he can solo kill the AM. I could be wrong, though, but if Black has the strength treads on and has his stick, I don't think God can kill him.
Maybe not.
Don't forget, AM has good base armor. He's got 9 armor. He still has the stout shield. It's better than nothing. It's not a Vanguard, but it's a stout shield. And some pretty good tank ability.
Looking at tier 2 tower trades right now. Mousesports looking to push out the bottom lane, but looks like they're going to fall back a little bit. God's making a move out, but there's still this ward here. So Kami wants to stand his ground. These trees are causing some issues right now.
And Dara again getting the way better trade on the pushing. They're getting a tier 2 tower for nothing.
Yep. And they might even get a kill on the bottom lane as well, just to boot. Come with me, he's being juked around by Goblin's trees the entire time. Now he's silenced up, and that's his death. Funnik TP'd in to Burrow, strike him down, and Prophet's ultimate just destroys him. And
that
pushes out all the lanes again.
And Aghanim's ulti dealt 379 damage, I think, after bouncing around the map a couple of times. And Goblin just continues his farming spree. And this looked very, very Mousesports early on, but that one fight in the middle, they lost 0-4, has really set them back. It opened up so much for Dara that Mousesports made this mistake. Mm-hmm. And now they're not looking back. It looks like Dara just winning everywhere. And the graphs, holy... Okay, yep. I did not expect this.
Yeah, it's a long way up for Dara.
10k on the XP with 4 kills advantage. And 7.5 in the gold.
Take that room, 1437. He needed it, but look at that. 3 clicks, didn't even need the 4th one, but did it nonetheless.
And Goblin... TP's in and he's like, my kill. And God doesn't get that, so even more farm for Goblin. I'm not sure what he's going to build next. We're probably going to see a Scythe of Vice against the Anti-Mage. Mm-hmm. I think a Medallion would be kind of useful for Dara as well to lock down that AM. Klinks is going to do so much more damage with that minus 6 armor that Goblin would be able to apply, and it's not an expensive item at all. He can buy that easily just now. It costs 1,075.
Smart time to borrow strike away, but there's still these sentry walls on the bottom lane. He's got all the vision in the world. And a kill for Come With Me. Man, look at our style. Instantly finds the trade. They lose SK on bot. Edict down the tier 2 tower. Fortification will save it for a denial. But there's three heroes coming in towards this middle lane, and Gold wants to kill here on Come With Me. And he's... Oh, no. Too much damage. And instantly another Sentry Ward goes down by Mousebots.
Yeah, and this is the thing about Clinks at this point. Mousebots are feeling super intimidated by him, so they keep dropping Sentry Wards everywhere. And that's really expensive to buy all these Sentry Wards all the time. Maybe they don't feel they can buy a gem for anyone right now because they're too afraid that they're going to lose it the moment they buy it.
Mm-hmm.
And, well, to me, the most concerning thing for Mousebots right now, I think Black is pretty much getting his farm. It could have been better, it could have been worse, but he's got 115 CS at this point, which is fine considering he didn't go to the Battle Fury. He's been harassed a little bit and stopped from farming. But Sing Sing on that Chaos Knight, he really doesn't have much. 70 CS, he doesn't have his... he's not close to his armlet. He's not close to... Well, he could buy his drum, but his farm is very delayed on that Chaos Knight.
We just saw dust pop off from Bamboo as well as the other ward, Sentry Ward, being dropped down by 1437. All in the search for a Klinks who Skeleton walked himself so fast away even the Fissure didn't hit.
And we're going to see Artstyle going for a Bloodstone, not the BKB. Gets the Bloodstone, so even bigger mana pool, even more for Black to crush. But also a lot of HP for Artstyle.
Is this one thing we have to...
And if he gets killed by Black, he heals his team up.
It's one thing we've got to keep looking at, though. Like, we've kind of almost transitioned past the days where it's not over while there's an AM on the field. I'm kind of feeling this way right now. Dara, they haven't really shut down Black a lot. Black has not died a single time. He's got 126 CS. He's not keeping up with Goblin, sure. Goblin's got 160 almost, and 3-for-1, and he's using Hand of Midas. So sure, Goblin's getting big. But if Black gets in there and starts locking him down, Prophet's items, they're very, very, well, it's stats and that's all. Black has free range with him. There's no BKB. There's nothing to really stop Black from doing damage. You got the Sprout. Black has Blink. There's nothing really Prophet does to counter him just yet. And I think you're right when you said the Scythe of Vice before has to come up from Prophet. Because if he doesn't have that, then Black's going to be picking him off wherever he can find him, or picking off all these other heroes on Dara's side.
Yeah, the question is how Dara are going to approach the team fights when they start coming up, because who do they use the Orchid on? Do they try to get AM to Blink and use the Manta Style and then find the right one and then Orchid that and lock it down? That's pretty hard.
But they can lock down Come With Me. He's about to get a Blink Dagger in the middle lane.
Yeah, they've got to lock down the Enigma so there's no Black Hole coming off. And even if the team fights happen, I think Dara are in a really bad position unless they have... Okay, they have the SK Blink now, so that helps them a lot, but... The teamfight potential of the Dire lineup is really good, of course. When you have Echo Slam and you have Black Hole, then you have several options of how to get into the teamfight, but if they all get cancelled out, you have nothing. That's the danger of playing Shaker and Enigma. Mm-hmm. If you don't get that big combo, you just don't have so much to bring to the fight.
But do you see the money up on this big combo? Bamboo is now farming at the top lane. He's almost got his Blink Dagger. Come With Me now has his Blink Dagger. He just bought and is flying out to him on the courier. The combo for Mousebots is almost ready. And when it comes for Dara's time to push in, I don't know if they'll have enough damage. AM will be able to stand and fight during these engagements, and then Dara will want to try and bring him down. But then they've got to try and focus on ES. They've got to try and focus on Come With Me. And if Come With Me and ES get their combo right, the Mana Style pops off from AM, and it becomes, well, a right-click destruction house for Mousebots.
Yeah, but speaking of right-click destruction house, you've got that Klinks.
Yeah, that's true. And now he's got BKB.
And he hits hard with BKB.
But if he gets caught inside that black hole, the BKB will only help him to a certain extent.
That's true. But it's a really... You're putting a lot of pressure on Enigma if he has to catch Klinks, Lesh, Wind, and Sand King to not get broken. Because they
come
all
with me
have
we're
black
about.
Hole breakers.
This is Come With Me we're talking about, Ben.
Yeah, sure. It's definitely possible. He has to be patient. And the problem is he might not... have the time to be patient, because if the opening comes from Dara, they kill fast. This Klinks four shots
Here's
the
patience.
Shadow Demon.
It's smoke time. Smoke gank time. They want to walk out here. They've still got that Blink Dagger up their sleeves on the Enigma, and they're looking to gank here on Arsile and Goblin. Who else is here? Farnaki's back there, but he's got the Blink, and he's sitting back. AM goes in first. Mana Style pops off. Urshaka jumps in as well. There goes the Epicenter, right through Sing Sing, right through 1437. Already down. Now Come With Me. The Black Hole will pop, and it does get gold with that BKB up, but it does not get Windrunner. He gets a Shackle, and there's the damage, and there is Mousebots sitting on the sidelines, just watching them, just... There goes tier 2, and probably tier 3 as well.
And Rax, if...
No, they're going to get Roshan.
They take Roshan for this? Okay.
Man, that combo did not work.
he went in there, he was considering, okay, maybe they gank us, and they drop a Fisher. They drop all AM stuff to try and kill off Artstar, and his team gets free play. Mm-hmm. Epicenter was nice, it hit two heroes for pretty much full damage. Then you've got Klinks completely free hitting until the Black Hole comes, but again, Sing Sing has nothing. So the Black Hole does nothing. They can't kill the hero inside it. Who's going to do the damage? If AM is on another target, they won't kill anyone in the Black Hole. He's all of their damage right now against the BKB heroes, and his damage isn't even that good anyway. He only has a Mantis Tile. He doesn't have, like, a Butterfly or perhaps a Battle Fury for that extra damage that that could give. Mm-hmm. He doesn't hit hard, so they don't really care. If Klinks gets the BKB off, I think he's almost immortal in the fight. He has 2,000 hit points. I mean, who's going to do that damage?
Not a lot of people right now, man. Not a lot of people
so
right now.
They have to get this farm up on Sing Sing. He needs to get something on that Chaos Knight.
The armlet
could work wonders already. It's a big upgrade for him to get that 500 hit points and the damage and then use Phantasm. I don't even think he got that off in the last fight, the Phantasm. It's not on cooldown.
Nope.
That's a big mistake, not getting that off in a fight like that, because it was obvious that fight was going to happen. When they went in an art style, they know it's going to happen. He has to use the Phantasm as the opener.
Hey, the problem was then for Mouse Balls, the fact that 1437 and Sing Sing, they went down low. The Fissure cut off, in the end, Mouse Balls themselves. It blocked them out. God, he's walking up here in Fizz.
There goes. Hit hard.
Nice time for a Sentry Ball by Come With Me. Funnick just sitting there on the sidelines. They're looking to go on black, but the support is still there by Mouse Balls, and this Black Hole is not up, and Funnick wastes his entire ultimate there. Black TP'd out the right time. Shackalore's Bamboo. Sing Sing, he's got to get this Phantasm off. He has done so. He's done a right click down. God, but God just destroys Enigma. Now he wants black. Cannot finish the job. Sing Sing's on low life. Arsar just standing his ground. Now 1437. There is nothing a support hero can do when that much damage is flying their way. And Windrunner Fish is off the Earthshaker as well, the Funnick was having fun with. And once again, Black the only one to survive.
And if a that bad initiation for Dera can give them a 4-0, I don't know how they can lose a fight.
I don't believe there is a way they
the
can lose a fight.
The epicenter was a complete flunk. It did nothing. The guard got caught off by a Fissure and a secondary stun, I think, and they still take it 4-0 without even getting close to dying.
Yep.
I've got to say, man, this one looks pretty over for me right now.
It's starting to feel that way, man. It's starting to feel that way. And the fact that Dera are inside the base, they're taking the melee racks, and now we're going to rotate towards the middle lane. Goblin's just... he's just standing his ground again, and if Black blinks himself in, he's now bought up a Basher, out of pure hope that he can hit hard enough to lock one of these heroes down. And he wants God, but God goes invis. There's no tower. The Sentry Wards, I believe, are now depleted. ES, he now has that Blink Dagger, blinks down for one Fissure on Arstyle, and Sing Sing looking for a Reality Rift, but not going to find one. Second Sentry Ward, maybe they're not expended. God going to come in. Funnick with a Burrow Strike. Shaka to follow up there. 1437, dead before it begins. Silence on Kalami 2. No Black Hole to come out from him. And there goes Klinks, killing off the Earthshaker. Now focusing on Black. Come with me, he wants that Black Hole. The arms went up, but Funnick went straight between his legs and dropped him down. Three heroes gone for Mouse Balls. Mid-racks will go, and the GG call comes out. Really, Dera, they're looking unstoppable, Sin. They're looking unstoppable going out into game two of this best of three for the lower bracket.
They're not looking unstoppable. They were looking a little crippled in the beginning, but then got a couple of good fights and made a nice comeback. But I thought Mouse had a really good shot at this when I saw how the start went. Considering they were running AM and CK and got off to a very nice start, they had the potential to snowball into a very powerful mid-late game, but then started getting caught off, and even though Goblin wasn't even part of the game until minute 8 or something on his Prophet, they still completely outfarmed and outplayed them on the map at that point. So Mousebots, they have to revise what went wrong and perhaps try to... yeah, I don't know. To me, when I saw the draft, the AM pick to me was a mystery. Why they got that. What was I expecting? I forgot. A Queen of Pain or something. Something to do the damage.
And
I think when you look at it, that's really what they were missing in this game. Anti-Mage never even became a problem, although he had free farm. He did nothing in the whole game. So, a Queen of Pain with that early level 6, the Sonic Wave and the Scream, who knows what she could have done around the map. But AM has to get the farm, and, well, at the point he had the farm, it was too late. So,
That is true, man. Gate number two, guys, stick around. We'll be coming in for that one. The winner of this will get to face up against Moscow Fire, possibly later tonight. But if Vlad's done what I hope he has done, he has delayed it until tomorrow. Remember, too, the Joint Outer Open finals will be happening up this evening. So that goes from the quarterfinals, semifinals, as well as the grand final. You can see it here on the live stream. It might impact here on the Star Ladder, the second final, or the final, however you want to say it in the lower bracket. Moscow Fire versus one of these guys. It might impact on that. So just bear that in mind, guys. We'll be back here with game number two, Dera versus Mouse Sports, coming up for you.